In today's Medico Apps Masterclass, we will talk about apoptosis. Apoptosis is programmed cell death or falling off. The three hallmark features of apoptosis is it is self-initiated, it is energy dependent, and there is no inflammatory response in apoptosis. Again, the three core and central features of apoptosis is it is self-initiated, it is energy dependent, and there is no inflammatory response. Due to any physiological or pathological causes, there is cell stress or injury. Physiological causes may involve organogenesis, aging, elimination of self-reacting lymphocytes. Pathological causes may involve DNA damage due to radiation, anti-cancer, cell infection, or even tumor cells. Once the cell is under stress or injury, this leads to the activation of caspases. Caspases are the central enzymes which coordinate the entire apoptosis. Once these caspases are activated, this leads to the degradation of DNA and final apoptosis. This apoptotic cell is finally phagocytosized. Let's move and look at the mechanism of apoptosis. Apoptosis, we know, is caspases dependent, and there are two pathways, intrinsic pathway and extrinsic pathway. Intrinsic pathway is also called as mitochondrial pathway, whereas extrinsic pathway is called as ligand or death receptor pathway. So intrinsic pathway is activated by the stress sensors. Stress sensor in the cell is BH3, whereas extrinsic pathway are activated by death receptors. Death receptors are CD95, tumor necrosis factor, and TRAIL. So once these factors are activated, these sensors are activated, this leads to the initiation phase of the apoptosis. Certain factors which promote intrinsic pathway are BAX, BAK, and BCLX. Also, cytochrome C leak is a promotory factor to intrinsic pathway, and apoptosome, which is cytochrome C plus apoptosis activating factor 1. So all these three are activators to intrinsic pathway. Certain inhibitors to intrinsic pathway are BCL1, BCL2, BCLXL, and MCL1. BCL stands for B-cell lymphoma. MCL stands for myeloid cell leukemia. Also, SMAC and Diabalo leak is an inhibitor to intrinsic pathway. So these are the inhibitors. Once this pathway is activated, this finally leads to the activation of caspases 9. So intrinsic pathway initiation phase ends with the activation of caspases 9, whereas in extrinsic apoptotic pathway, FAS and FAS ligand, actually there is a tetramerization which leads to the activation of caspases 8 or caspases 10 in cases of human. So intrinsic pathway initiation phase ultimately leads to the activation of caspases 9, whereas extrinsic pathway ultimately leads to the activation of either caspases 8 or caspases 10 as in humans. This leads to the execution caspases or the execution phase. Execution caspases are C3, C6 and C7. So these are the execution caspases. Once they are activated, they lead to the increase in the cell membrane permeability, cleave the cytoskeleton and cleave the nuclear component. So these three execution caspases leads to the increase in the membrane permeability, the cleave the cytoskeleton and cleave the nuclear component, which finally leads to the apoptosis of the cell, and the altered cell get phagocytosized. As we move forward, let's look at the morphological changes which happens in the cell in cases of apoptosis. So this is the normal cell. Once the signal happens of apoptosis, there is a cell shrinkage and chromatin condensation. Then what happens, there is bleb formation on the cell membrane and the organelle starts to disintegrate. This finally continues and the nucleus collapses. Once the nucleus collapses, apoptotic bodies are formed, and these apoptotic bodies are phagocytosized. One important point again, that there is no inflammation involved in apoptosis. apoptosis. The marker of apoptosis is annexin 5. This has been asked so many times. Marker for apoptosis is annexin 5. And the flipping of phosphatidylserine is from inside to outside. So these two questions on apoptosis has been regularly asked. Some extra edge questions. Which enzyme is activated for nuclear fragmentation of apoptosis? The answer is endonuclease. Which molecule is the hallmark of neuronal apoptosis? The answer is apoptosis inducing factor. Which caspase is involved in extrinsic pathway in human? The answer is caspase 10. Memory B lymphocytes are protected from apoptosis by which molecule? The answer is nerve growth factor. Let me tell you a certain difference. Cell death or induction can happen in form of necrosis, apoptosis or autophagy. We need to know the difference between these three. Basically, in necrosis there is cellular swelling, in apoptosis there is cellular shrinkage, and in autophagy there is increase in the autophagosome. Also, in necrosis intracellular membrane dilatation happens, in apoptosis DNA fragmentation happens, and in autophagy ALT-ATG protein participation, that is autophagy related protein participation happen. The most critical difference is in apoptosis and autophagy there is no inflammation involved, whereas in necrosis inflammation is involved. This brings us to the end of the apoptosis with Medico Apps Masterclass. Thank you.